If you're ready and you're wanting to start, that's fine.
I'm ready.
You ready?
Yeah.
Okay.
Good morning, everyone. My name is Popalina Petra, and I study at National High School Karate for Sparta, and I'm a team member from Team Romania. I'll present program number 2, Golden Air Horn. Let's first read the balloon air horn sentence. A simple balloon can be constructed by stretching a balloon over the opening of a small container or cup with a tube to the other end, like the pink gear below. Blowing through a small hole in the side of the container can produce a sound. Investigate how relevant parameters affect the sound. When I first started with this experiment, my first intention was to produce a balloon air horn with the capability of making sound. After this, I realized the balloon air horn. I managed to do some theoretical model associated with it. We know that the sound is an oscillation that can be precise by the ear, and it as being an oscillation by transferring into an elastic environment between with the transfer of energy between environment particles without the substance transport, calling mechanical wave. We have two types of mechanical waves, longitudinal waves and transversal waves. We know that the waves are characterized by five amplitude, frequency, period, wavelength, and angular frequency. The relations between frequency and period are the following. Frequency equals 1 ratio period and angular frequency ratio to B. And the speed of the wave is defined by the following relation. Wavelength multiplied by frequency. We know that when longitudinal waves are propagating in a liquid, in our case in the air, they kept a definite length of the tube. The wave is reflected in one way and in the opposite direction. And by overlapping these two waves created, we obtain the stationary wave. Many musical instruments use this type of wave by transforming air vibration into musical sound. For the balloon air horn, we have the next situation for the lower frequency. This is the first harmonic model. With a closed end with the balloon membrane, the open end with the air as it enters the tube, the waveform, and the length of the tube as a quarter of the wavelength. We know that the points where the amplitude is null are called nodes, and the points where the amplitude is at its maximum point are called venters or antinodes. The distance between a node and his antinode is always a quarter of the wavelength. For a one-end membrane closed tube, the length of the tube is a quarter of the wavelength, and the fundamental frequency is defined by the following relation. Speed of the wave, ratio wavelength. The next mode is corresponding to the third harmonic model with the air as it enters the tube, and the length of the tube as 3/4 of the wavelength. And so on, we will develop the relation for the third harmonic model with the frequency as 3 equaling with 3 multiplied by fundamental frequency, and the vibration mode for the fifth harmonic model, 5 multiplied by fundamental frequency. This is the fifth harmonic model with the length of the tube as 5/4 of the wavelength. We will obtain the generalization for the n-level harmonic model, that the fundamental for the n-level harmonic model will be n multiplied by fundamental frequency. We can observe that the even harmonics are missing. The experimental method, how we will make the balloon air horn. We will use one plastic container, one balloon, one scissors, one straw, and 2 thin elastic rings. We will make 2 holes into the canister, one on the small base and one on the lateral, and take out the cover from the bigger base. We will now cut the balloon in order to obtain a diaphragm and tighten it really hard using 2 thin elastic rings, putting it on the now open end at the bigger base. At the end, we will introduce the straw into the canister until it slightly presses the diaphragm. The parameters that are influencing the sound are length of the tube diameter, and tightness of the diaphragm, because if the diaphragm will not be tightened enough, the sound will not be produced, as the vibration will not be made. We made some experiments using 5 different straws of different lengths and different colors. One of 90 millimeters length, 100 millimeters length, 150, and 230 millimeters length. The dimensions of the balloon air horn are the following ones. speed diameter 70 millimeters, small diameter 15 millimeters, and height 83 millimeters. For each throw, we recorded the result itself. And we made the correspondence between the sound obtained with the air horn and the sound obtained with the pen. I can assure you that I studied pen when I was 5 years old, and I'm not really sure if my pen teacher would be delighted with the sound I obtained. This is the sound for the shortest throw of 90 millimeters length. And together with the piano, they are corresponding to note Do from the piano. For the third one of 150 millimeters length. And together with the piano, they are corresponding to note Mi, first octave under the center octave. For the fourth throw of 150 millimeters length, the sound obtained with the piano. Together with the air horn and the piano. The second one of 100 millimeters length. This is the sound obtained with the air horn. And the instrument and the air horn, corresponding to note C. And for the last row and the longest row of 230 millimeters length, we obtain the following sound. And together with the piano, they are corresponding to note by the second octave under the central one. We made the conclusion that by shortening the tube, the sound produced will become higher and louder. The longer the air horn will be, the lower the note. Here we have a graphical representation between the length of the tube used and the note corresponding to each of them. Here we have some experimental data. The colors of the tube, the length of each tube, the note corresponding to each of them. The frequency corresponding to each note according to the Acoustical Foundation of Music, Bacchus, New York, the calculated wavelength, the calculated tube length as a quarter of the wavelength, and the errors. We can observe that the errors are very big for the last two strokes of 150 and 230 millimeter length, and we decide that we will give up on them because we would need strokes with length over 400 millimeters in order to continue our experiment. More than that, using that software, we get the confirmation that the last two strokes were out of our initial interpretation, and the first three were very close to the estimated sounds analyzed. Here we have the frequency for the first stroke of 90 millimeters length as almost 260 as obtained with the air horn and the piano. For the 100 millimeters length too, and for 115, but here we can observe that for the one we gave up first of 150 millimeters length, they are not defined by only one frequency, and for the longest one too. We will adjust the tubes to the new dimensions. We will make the first tube from 19 millimeters length existing to 82 millimeters length as obtained from calculation. The second tube will become from 100 millimeters, 87 millimeters, and the third tube will become from 115, 130 millimeters, and we will redo the experiment. Having good length of the tube will let us obtain sounds of a better accuracy from the smallest length to the biggest. This is the first one, so from the center of that for the stroke, 82 millimeters length. From the small octave for the stroke 87. third one and the last one. Need from the small of that for the stroke of 130 millimeters length. Human audio spectrum precise sounds between 20 and 20,000 hertz. And the allocation process of different musical notes to frequencies is called granting of the musical note. In musical industry, the granting of the musical note has a reference to note law with an associated frequency of about 440 hertz. We will now increase the diameter of the stroke from existing 5 millimeters to 9 millimeters and observe the correlations. What is sure is the fact that the frequency will not change because we keep the same turbulence. But in real life, by increasing the diameter of the stroke, the sound obtained from the air horn will become stronger and louder. This is the bibliography that helped me in obtaining this experiment. Thank you for your attention.
Thank you. Questions now from the opposition?
Okay, thank you. I do appreciate your presentation. So I have several questions. Firstly, what are the three basic elements of sound?
Of the sound.
Okay. Frequency, amplitude,
and
timbre, right?
And intensity.
And then you've talked about the infrasound and ultrasound at the beginning. Do you think that these are also sounds that we should investigate?
Yes.
Okay.
But we are not very sure if we can obtain frequencies as big as for ultrasound.
Thank you. And which part of the air horn is vibrating? Is it only the air in the pipe?
The air in the pipe pushes the diaphragm, and the diaphragm then pushes the stroke, and the air inside the stroke.
Okay, I understand your point. Thank you. And do you think that the film will vibrate too? The film, do you think it will vibrate?
Yes.
Okay, we can talk about that later in more details. And then, under what condition will your balloon air horn be operating? Under what condition?
When we blow air into the small hole, the air pushes.
At whatever speed? Okay.
Not at any speed, because the sound will not be produced if the speed is not big enough.
We can also discuss that in more details later. And then, because of which wave of the sound can the air inside the tubes form a standing wave? You talk about the two waves of the sound.
The reflected wave and the obtained wave. Together they form the stationary wave.
Okay, and what is your purpose of comparing your sound of the album with the piano?
It was more like creativity because, as I said, I studied piano for a very long time and I associated the frequencies from the musical notes of the piano with the frequencies obtained with the
air. Okay, and do you think your expression of the frequency as the musical sound is scientific enough?
Probably.
Okay, thank you. And that is all my short question.
Thank you. You now have.
Okay, good morning. I'm Yu Tan from Team China, and I will be opposing problem number two, balloon air horn. And the problems require us to investigate to investigate how the relevant parameters will affect the sound made by the balloon air horn. And from the reporter's presentation, you can find that she analyzed the sound and relevant parameters. However, the analysis of these two keywords are incomplete. For example, element of the sound and not enough parameters. And in the experiment, she has made some significant phenomena, which is quite good. And however, in the theoretical analysis, I think that she only considered the standing wave in the pipe and the higher orders of standing wave. However, there might be much more of components of the sound made by the balloon air horn, and we think we can discuss that later. Experiments, she has quantitatively investigated the tube diameter and length of the influence on the balloon air horn, but she has unsuccessfully controlled other variables like the surface tension and density of the film, and she has a qualitative self-consistency with theory. So in the theoretical analysis, I think she has considered the sound, nature of the sound, which is quite good. However, she's unclear about the nature of the sound, probably, and not enough analysis of the timbre. And her approximations of the two-dimensional actual systematic system is partially proper, and she has a reasonable priority of the L inside the tube's vibration. However, more types of vibration must also be considered, and she had a quite complete analysis of the standing wave and qualitatively explained most phenomena. However, I think she has an inadequate discussion of sound and considered the vibration of only the pipe and investigated the vibration of the film as an analytical process, and she overlooked the interaction between the film and pipe, which we think requires coupling. And she dismissed the threshold and critical conditions during which this balloon L horn can operate. And maybe we think that she has missed the deeper physics about the external flow inspiring the eigenfrequency of the system. So in experiment, we think that she has verified the theory with appropriate tests of some parameters, though not enough, and just relatively adequate discussion, and her nice live presentation, even relating to some of her personal experience. I think this is really creative. And she has a reasonable error explanation, and has a creative expression of the musical sound, which I think is very creative. However, it is not very accurate scientifically. And she could have tested more parameters, including container shape, size, and the position of the hole. And she lacked a direct observation of the vibration forms and position, which can help her verify the theory. And she is unable to control the adequate variables as shown above. And the presentation of data, though creative, is unconvincing scientifically. So here are the advices that we have for the reporter. We think that she can consider deeper physics of the phenomena to investigate all possible vibrations and the part of vibration, for example, the film or the film and the type as a complete system. I think she should also analytically solve the asymmetric vibration on the external forces of the film and consider how the L horn operates in different conditions, how it will vibrate or produce sound if the flow rate is different. And I think that she should couple the film and the pipe for a comprehensive solution of the sound. Meanwhile, I think that she should investigate more variables as requested by the problem, such as the container shape, size, the hole position and size, and other factors of the pipe or the film. And these and below are my outline of discussion. And let's move on to this phase. Okay, so first about your perceiving of the problem. First about your perceiving of the sound. I mean that about the three basic elements of sound, you have only investigated frequency. If I'm not mistaken,
this is frequency, and I talked about amplitude.
Qualitative talk about amplitude, right? Yes. So, how do you think you can reflect timbre if you would like to study that? Because it is also an important element of the sound, right?
Yes, it's an important element. So, as one of the three definitions.
So how do you think we can investigate it?
Maybe, in my opinion, as I made the correspondence between the piano and the air horn, we can associate it with another musical instrument, because the same note has different amplitude in different musical instruments.
That is possible, but we suggest that more quantitatively you can study the distribution of frequency of sound to make it more analytical and scientific. And then another part, you said about the infrasound and ultrasound. Then, but you have not experimented with this, right?
I didn't manage to obtain such a high frequency as 20,000 hertz.
So we suggest.
Were you able to obtain it?
Yeah. So we suggest that you can probably use some electronic device to capture the sound and analyze it of the more range of the results. And then we can probably talk about the your theory before we analyze the parameters. Okay. Then in your theory, you only consider the standing wave inside the pipe. Though I think your consideration of standing wave is quite adequate. However, have you ever put your finger on the film when you are blowing into it? When you are blowing into the album?
Yes, and it kind of stopped the moving of the diaphragm.
Yeah, so could you predict that
So do you think that the film will also operate, will also vibrate and make part of the sound?
Yes, but the sound will not be as clear, or it will make just a vibration, and the sound will not be produced.
Oh, okay. So maybe that shows here. Actually, I think that you could have analytically. No, maybe not this one. That's why. Okay. I think that you could have analytically solved the vibration of the film and the reverb property. First, let's look at the basic structure of the balloon album. As is shown in your model, can we come
briefly?
Okay. So when the air is blown into the hole here, the pressure inside will increase, and the film will. Yes, right. So could you please predict how we can solve the equation of the film?
The second member, sit down now, please.
So we suggest that you should integrate the vibration of the film and the tube, because this tube, on one side, it is covered by the film, right? So the air flow inside it is largely influenced by the vibration of the film, right?
Yes.
But you can come here to make it clear, because maybe you cannot see it. So we suggest that you should consider the vibration using the equation of film vibration. Right? So that is also another component of the sound. And so now we can talk about. So what do you think that if you have not considered the vibration of film? How can you verify its relationship with the sound of the pipe with the experiment?
I varied another parameter.
Well, but you have.
I told you that I varied more the frequency and the length of the tube and the diameter of the tube. I understand that the tension in the film is another important parameter, but I don't think it's as important as the ones I mentioned.
But as we must be clear, the vibration is an interaction between the film and the tube, right? They are a whole system. So we cannot analyze the vibration of the air inside the tube separately from the film, right? And in your reading that maybe to verify this, you should put two microphones at the film side and tube side to record the sounds on different positions, right?
Then don't you think that the sound will be perturbed by the background sampling as a registration?
Well, that is a control of the experiment, but it is avoidable, right?
It's extremely avoidable.
Okay.
Because if you put the microphones at both ends, do you think the sound will be registered?
Okay. So have you ever changed the film of your own?
Yes.
So what influence will that have? Because you have not analyzed the film condition in your theory.
I haven't analyzed the film condition in my theory.
Yes.
I have changed the balloon in my experiment.
So what was the difference?
The sound was extremely close to one to another because I haven't changed the tightness. The two inelastic rings were put in the same position.
Okay, so
I think that is another parameter that is influencing.
Yeah, so we suggest that you can investigate more parameters of that film, and maybe that will make a change. And in your experiment, which part of the balloon do you choose to make that film? Is that an even part?
It's
half a circle of it?
Approximately.
Okay, so you must make sure that the mass distributes evenly inside
yes.
it, which is quite difficult for a common balloon, actually. And it's okay that we can talk more about your experiment. Your experiment, have you directly observed the oscillation of the film?
Yes. Because when you blow the air, you see as the diaphragm is moving.
Yeah. So it is hard for us to understand why don't you investigate theoretically. But as you have investigated much on the pipe, we will just focus on the discussion of pipe. Okay. In your experiment, you only test with the length and the radius of the and radii of your pipe, right? So you compare the results with the sound made by the piano.
Yes.
So do you think that it would be better if you directly record the sound and use the computer to analyze it?
Yes, I actually use the computer as I showed you here with methods of interpreting the frequencies.
But your presentation of the result, you did not present persuasively scientific results of it. Because I see from your presentation that you only talk about the frequency and the only about the frequency of the sound. I think other parameters of the sound relating to the basic elements of it should also be reflected from it, right? And still about the pipe, for you may study this. Have you ever changed the sticking distance of the pipe out of the film? I mean,
yes,
if you push it further inside.
Influencing parameter.
So how about it influence?
The sound when you slightly press the diaphragm, the sound produces clear, and when you push it even more, the sound is not as clear as before.
And have you controlled other variables when doing this experiment?
I've thought about changing the material of the tube, as I use plastic tubes.
Oh, okay, so we think that, actually, I think you might have misunderstood my question. I mean the control of variables. For example, when you are sticking the tube further into the film, the properties of the film might change as well.
Yes.
So we suggested that you should...
it will not be able enough to make the same moves as easy.
So we suggest that you can first draw a circle at the center of your tube, and then evenly stretch the tube to once more cover the opening. So by this way, you can control the other parameters the same. Okay? And please turn to page 35 of your upper PowerPoint. Page 35 of your why are there frequencies that is several times
the
off?
Frequencies that we studied are in the first graphic in the and I said that we didn't manage to make the correspondence between the piano with the longer stroke.
Well,
this is the one we gave up.
Well, so we think that this explanation is not persuasive and scientific enough.
Okay, time.
Maybe
time. Thank
time.
You.
And I will make a conclusion for one.
No. Yes.
Okay, so we have made a valuable discussion with the reporter. The reporter has only considered about the influence of the pipe, so we suggested that she should also consider the vibration of the film and the integration of film and pipe. And just upon the point of the pipe, we think that she should change other variables, like the sticking distance of the pipe onto the film, and this is not presented in her report. Moreover, we think that the vibration of other parts of the balloon airhole is also essential to this problem, like the vibration of the film and the integration of these two parts of vibration. And I think that she might have missed the physics of the external flow inspiring the eigenfrequency of this system, which I think she should have mentioned in it, but we were unable to adequately discuss this because of this understanding. Thank you.
Thank you very much. Okay, questions please from the reviewer to both the reporter and the opponent.
Okay, so firstly I want to thank for the discussion between the reporter and the opponent, but somehow I have still have some questions toward the reporter. So first, you mentioned about the resonance as the main factor that will make the air horn to make the sound, right? So did you consider the airflow inside the tube, which will also maybe will influence the sound of the airflow? Okay, so also for the opponent, how do you think that the airflow inside the pipe will affect or influence
the resonance? So the resonance is essential, but the reporter has not discussed this system to analyze this resonance, because we need to consider both the outflow inside the tube and the computer in the front.
I got your point. Yes, thank you. So for our next questions for our reporter, can you turn to page 24? Thank you. Because from the report during the presentation of the reporter, we have heard that on page 24, the sound she placed out have been shaking. So we know that it's not for one note. So can you please explain more? How did you make the sound of the air horn? Did you use your mouth to blow it?
Yes, I said before in the experiment that we'll make the hole in the letter in order for me
so
to blow.
So do you think that this record of the sound will is a good data for you to analyze? Because the sound is shaking.
It's shaking. Yes, but the
maybe it will affect
speed
the
of the blowing air was pretty constant.
Okay, so for a moment, how do you think it will affect?
Well, I think it is necessary to do some control of outflow, to use a constant flow of air to drive this
Okay, thank you. I got your point. So for the reporter, can you turn to page 31? Because from her graph, like the opponent just pointed out that there are many harmonics we can see in this graph. We can see this graph. So can you explain more what causes the harmonics?
The frequencies we studied are in the first graphic in the left here.
Okay, so what do you think it will affect your experiment results?
The frequency?
The frequency? Okay, thank you. So the opponent, this question is for opponent, because you have mentioned about in your report that you have mentioned about the natural sound. So what is the natural sound you mentioned? Is that the natural sound of the membrane, the pipe, or
do you
the air
flow inside? You mean the eigenfrequency, the natural sound?
Yeah.
So we think we should that the reporter should integrate both the vibration of the film and the pipe, because the airflow in the pipe is influenced by the film, and this system has the eigenfrequency. That is the natural sound that you can just mention.
Okay, so for another point, you have mentioned about maybe she can record the ultrasound from her experiment. So how can you record the ultrasound? Because we know that ultrasound we can't hear it.
Oh, we can't hear it, but
time. Thank you.
Okay.
Just finish the answer.
Oh, because we cannot directly hear it, but we can use some mechanical or electronic device to do so.
Right.
Okay,
thank you.
Good morning, I'm the reviewer from Team Taiwan, and today I'm going to review problem number 2, bullet air horn. So this is the problem statement, and I will just quickly go for it. So we have to produce a sound according to the air horn that we use a small container to blow out the sound, and we have to investigate it from random parameters, what will affect the sound. So this is the outline for the reporter. First, she didn't have a clear observation video to show us how is the observation looks like, and it's, yes, it's like complete video. And she second of us, she talks about her theory, and she has the principle of the mechanic wave, and she calculating the wave then from her experiment, and she also explained the standing wave, and it's about the closed end. And she's never relevant to the theory, and she has too much work and did not explain it very well. And about her experiment, I really appreciate that she has making process very clear, and she shows the sound. She shows us the sound of the air horn she blows out, and she makes the blown air horn as many parameters. The first one is the different length of the straw, and the insert then she pops out of the tube. And she should deeper analyze on the sound, and she should show us more graph about her experiment data. And her setup is not so well, and I think she can improve it about the membrane part or the tube part. And she still can do some more parameters. And for the conclusion, she has no obvious conclusion, and we think she can make her conclusion more clear than we can understand. So this is the first discussion between the opponent and the reporter about the chamber. The opponent asks about what will the chamber affect the sound, and what is the spectrum of the sound. And the reporter answered that the chamber is one of the sounds that she can record to analyze. And what we think is that we believe there is the wave packets of the of her experiment. And what will influence the wave packets are the flow inside the tube, which will make the higher harmonics. And for the second clash between the opponent and the reporter, the opponent asks whether she should consider the motion of the film and what would affect if she changed the film. And the reporter said she thinks that is important, which will affect her experiment. And what we think is that the tension might slightly change when the flow condition change, and it will influence the frequency, which will magnify under a high flow rate. So maybe she can change. She can consider this part. And for a third clash between the opponent and reporter, they discussed about using a computer to analyze the sound. And the reporter answered that yes, she used the MATLAB to analyze the sound of her data. And the reporter thinks that the spectrum was shown in page 31 to 34. We can see there are harmonics. So maybe the reporter should analyze the harmonics more. So for one, they talk about the instrument, and the opponent asks about this, and the reporter answered that the sound will not be very clear. And the reporter thinks that the flow condition should also change, so they should observe it more. So for point miss, the reporter didn't do the cup size, which will affect the pressure inside the tube, and also the airflow. It will cause the vortex, which will help the resonance. I think the reporter should point it out. And also the tube radius, it will affect the radius. It will affect the frequency of the sound. And also the membrane, what is the shape of the wave packet? And for a conclusion, that maybe we suggest the reporter to use the air compression to control the flow rate. And also she should analyze more about the spectrum and standing wave, and also the secondary factor. And for the opponent part, we think that opponent point out merit points, but still from their discussion, we hope that the opponent can discuss more about the experiment result with the reporter. Thank you.
Thank you very much. Minutes for concluding remarks from the reporter, please. Reset the clock, please. Just wait.
So, for the balloon air from some of my conclusion remarks, I think I kind of had a good qualitative explanation of the phenomenon both theoretically and experimentally. And the explanation of the phenomenon using the stationary waves appeared in a tube were presented using the harmonics and the third and fifth harmonic model generalizing. I got a good correlation between sounds produced and the air horn and the piano between using the frequencies. And the experimental setup was pretty good realized. The good variation of the parameters, I varied the length, I varied the tube radius too. And the sources of errors and ways to optimize our experiment are pretty clear that the background sounds were very or very harmful in our obtaining of the sound. The frequencies used here are very close to the experimental setup. As I tried to explain to the reviewer and the opponent, that was the original graph between the magnitude and the low frequency. That these are the graphics between the noise. And we see that it is about 250, and our calculated one was about 260, letting us obtain good results. Thank you very much for your attention.
Okay, we now have some questions from the jury to clarify the situation for all three of you for 5 minutes. So any jury member who would like to start with a question, please. Locke.
Okay. Can you show the picture of the frequency spectrum? Can you comment? First, there's no unit, so I wonder if this 5 minutes first, the first one, the low frequency.
Yeah.
Yeah, so you see the very large peak. And the next one is like at around 500 or 600, around there. So is that the second harmonic or?
No, that's the first harmonic. The first harmonic.
Oh, sorry, the first harmonic. So just now in your theory, you mentioned there's only the third, three times F. The second one is not there, and the third one is there, but this one is like contradict what you said in the theory, right?
I said that even harmonic models are missing because we have an open closed tube. If the even harmonic model would appear, it would be an open tube, and that's why the frequencies are not here.
Okay.
I have a question for the reporter. After you cut the saw to make it shorter to match the theory, have you ever checked if the frequency is still the same?
No, because I thought that only the length of the tube is influencing the frequency. And actually, when I measured it, I observed that the sounds were very close to the estimate sound because we cut the throws in order for them to be at exactly the frequency of the musical note.
Okay. Any other questions from the jury?
Okay. Do you consider temperature would have been played a role over here?
No, I don't consider temperature as a
parameter. Okay, I have a question for all three. Do you consider this tube to be closed or open at the diaphragm end?
Oh, I think it is between the state of open and closed.
Thank you.
I think it is, I agree with the point because the film will go out and we will close the tube, so it is closed.
I agree with them, open, closed tube.
Okay, thank you. Small amount of time for an additional clarifying question, if anyone has one. Yes?
So I'd like to go back to these graphs. So what's the difference between original wave and noise wave?
Between that graph and?
Yes, the left column and the right column, they look the same to me. So why you show us two different columns?
I showed them because they were notated that this was the sound and this was obtained like the background sound influencing noise, as the noise.
Just a follow-up?
They look, yes, one follow-up.
All right, and then so for all three of you, so notice that on the top graph, there's one big line followed by maybe some very small ones, but then in the middle one, something at about 2,300, something, a big line pops up again. So what do you think that all these extra lines might be? Sure.
I think that's the frequency multiplied, and that is caused by the unsymmetry of the system, because it's not symmetric, it's not two-dimensional axis symmetric. So the unsymmetry will cause the frequency multiplied.
Reporter, would you like to say something?
Yes, we studied only the low frequencies because that were in our margin of error. So we haven't went to the graphics for medium and high frequencies. But I think they are variating because the sound was transformed in waves, as recording. The quality was not the same.
Okay, but and one, and Locke, one quick one.
Yeah, opponent, you said wave, the membrane is important, the film is important.
Essential.
Also is important.
Well, because firstly, the membrane itself will vibrate, and secondly, when the film vibrates, it will largely affect the flow condition at the end of the tube.
How does it affect the frequency? How does it affect the frequency?
The boundary conditions of it, because
we're getting into too far into the depth of it. They meant simply to be clarifying. Thank you very much. The jury will now consider their scores, please. Let's go to the reporter, please. Four, five, five, six, four. Thank you. And for the opposition, seven, six, eight, eight, seven. And for the review, eight, six, seven, eight, six. Now for the comments from the jury, for the report, if I could ask perhaps the high score, six.
For me, she initially started very well explaining all the concepts, except for missing some of the concepts. If you would have answered your opponent properly, I would have gone a little bit higher also.
Okay. There are two of us on fours.
I'm surprised that you said at the reasoning from jury that you believe that the theory involved is both open ends and closed ends, but you only present the closed end.
Yes.
That's why I said four.
I felt there was, your presentation was basically good. Your work with the piano was good, but it wasn't, you didn't back up the science of what you were doing. As we were listening, I didn't think the notes matched what you were producing. I may be wrong, but I thought, I haven't got a good ear, I didn't think they matched terribly well, or made a scientific point of where you were going. And perhaps you might have discussed a bit more about the quality of the sound at that point, because you had it with your piano, and you could have compared it to the other. For the opposition, low score of six, is what?
Yeah. So for the opponent, I think why I think you mentioned that the film is important, but to the discussion, it doesn't seem to bring up the physics why it's important.
Well,
it's not clear how you. I mean, I understand that maybe you deal with the boundary condition, but the most important thing is that the result. How does it affect the frequency and things like that? So I think that part is not shown sharp. Second thing is that you mentioned the piano part, which in fact the reporter did have the spectrum available. So I think that part of the position has to be
okay. Would either of the eights want to comment on your position? No? Yes.
Okay. Yeah, I think that you covered all the almost all the relevant points that she might have missed out. So the only I think you ran out of time at the end to discuss something that's more relevant to the frequency spectrum that she presented, and I thought that was a very important point. Mm-hmm. So your prioritization of what you're going to talk about didn't come true.
I agree. And for the review, low score, either of the sixes like to comment.
Again, that's something about the last question from the jury, that you think that the phenomenon is both open-ended and closed-ended altogether, and you have said the theory or something else in your terms when you said you have to present that. Another thing is that six is not low for me.
Mm.
I have to qualify. you said that there are some missing physics and you give some suggestion, but that's not going deep enough. That what kind of physics that you like to see is why I gave you this.
Thank you. As for the eight, I thought you covered the situation really well. You used the time very effectively. You had a good selection of questions and clearly a good understanding of the problem. So I was more than pleased with that as outcome. Thank you. We'll have a 10-minute break before we get back to stage two.